Billy says not to talk to you. How's it going out there in the wastes? Landmines are one of the few dangers out there that you can profit from. Disarm one before it blows, and you can sell it for plenty of caps. I've heard stories about a ghost town that's just full of mines. Traders just call the place Minefield. Sounds like the place for some field work. Get in there, get back, and tell me all about it. And could you bring back a mine for my studies? Oh, don't worry. No one ever goes there because they say it's a ghost town. And since ghosts don't exist, you can just focus on the landmines. I hear there's a playground in the middle of town. Reach that point and come back, and I'm sure you'll have some stories to tell. What do you need? Don't hurt yourself. See?
Tamper with that, and we're going to have a problem.
Yeah. Thank you. Those monsters, they're gonna get me. Those things, they keep coming. They scare me. Make it stop. You look stronger than all the other grown-ups. Can you protect me? Those big things, they're all over Great Itch, and they killed everyone. Please, please find my papa. You will? Really? Thanks a whole lot. My house is the one closest to the huge sign and the old diner. Please, find my papa and make him come back. You know, maybe this will help, and maybe it won't. but Papa hid a bunch of stuff behind the old diner and a dumpster. He trusted me with the key and said it was for emergencies, but I bet he wouldn't mind you having it. Well, there is the personal shelter next to the old diner. Papa always said to stay away from it, but I guess it's supposed to be safe. I'll head over there and wait inside. Hurry back.
Thank you. damn it! Yes?
Ah, welcome, weary traveler. You look like a traveler in need of relaxation and the finest of chemical assistance. Well, wander no more, my good friend, for I am Doc Hoff, procurer of the finest of medical goods and chemical assistance. Now, how may I help you? Tell me what you need, and maybe I've got your fix. Give me a shout if you need anything else. See you next.
Good to see you.
Ah, hello.
Hey. Hey.
Hang on, you're not one of them. I nearly blasted you in two. Get over here before they spot you. Now what the hell are you doing all the way out here? That's great, but I got bigger problems than being the town post office right now. The shit's about to hit the fan in this cesspool, and I don't think I can stop them. Well, at first, they do their typical gang bullshit. You know, break stuff and make lots of noise. But they always kept their distance. But this last time, they went too far. They killed all of our Brahmin. I mean, that's our lifeblood out here, you know. Look, you can call me crazy if you want. But there is something odd about those creeps. I mean, they got the guns and they got the muscle. Why don't they just bust down our doors and take us out already? We're really in a bad way, and could use some help. I don't want to take my eyes off the ramp here. There's no telling when the family will return. Can you do me a favor and check on the other people's houses here? You know, make sure they're doing okay? Speak with Davis West, Karen Shenzi, and Ken Ewers. I can't take that. You're just going to have to bring it to the West yourself. There used to be more families living here. Most of them have dismantled their shacks and moved on to greener pastures. Those that are still living here are keeping themselves indoors, thanks to the family. I think they live somewhere east or northeast of here. Problem is, they always travel in the dark, so I can't see exactly where they go. There's all kinds of places they could be hiding, like Hamilton's Hideaway, the old Moonbeam Cinema, or Northwest Seneca Metro Station. Just watch yourself. I've got an itchy trigger finger.
Hello? Is this the mailman? Oh, I do hope my fall catalog has arrived. Oh, Evan, he's such a gentleman. Please, do come inside. Let me unlock the door for you.
What the hell are you doing in here? Get the fuck out.
Yeah, right. And the second I drop my guard, you pounce. No thanks. Look, speak your piece, then leave. We're great. Just peachy. I love sitting in my house with my thumb up my ass. Tell Mr. King that sitting here all day isn't going to make us any safer. We need to take action. Everyone is keeping themselves safe from the family. If I was you, I'd do the same. You want to know more? Talk to Evan King. They're low-life scum who decided to use Arafu as their own personal amusement park. Oh, they're a fun bunch. I'd take a shot at them if I could, but judging from what they did to the Brahmin, I wouldn't live long to tell about it. Well, he's town mayor or sheriff or whatever he calls himself. He calls all the shots. When he says to get the heck indoors and stay put, we do that. Good. Now get out.
You must be exhausted from all that walking in this horrible heat. Oh, and hungry too. Sit, please. Braley Ewers is the name. Don't mind my husband, Kenneth. He woke up on the wrong side of the bed this morning. Oh, he's such a dear. I must remember to make more of those preserves he loves so much. Oh my, I don't know. Mrs. West is probably whipping up a batch of her famous cookies, and all the kids are playing in the yards. It's so nice outside. The grass looks lovely this time of year. Oh, certainly. Close the front gate when you leave, and mind my begonia garden. I just planted them.
Hey.
Good to see you.
Yes. Who is it? Oh, he did? Well, it's about damn time he did something. Come on in. I'll unlock the door.
It's nice to see a friendly new face around here. It's been a long time. The name's Karen Shenzi. Scared out of my mind. I'm glad he's checking on us, but until someone nips the problem in the bud, we may as well stay inside forever. We're scared shitless. Evan King's got everyone so worked up about the family, no one wants to set foot outside. That asshole runs the show. But does he really do anything about our problem? No. All they do is terrorize us. They taunt us to open our doors, throw bottles at our houses, and scream at us. If I knew King had my back, I'd step outside and show them just how I feel about their visits, especially after this last attack. He's a spineless wimp. His best solution to the family is to stay inside our homes and hide. What does that tell them? It tells them that we can be pushed around whenever they want. I'm sick of it, and I'm sick of King. Sure, go. Just like everyone else.
Thank you.
What did they tell you? Everyone okay? The family must have gotten to them in the last attack. Sons of bitches. Damn it! If only we had more men, we could stand up to them. I'm sick of them terrorizing this town. Wait a minute. When you searched the West's place, did you find their son Ian's body? This has to be the work of the family. I've caught that weirdo leader of theirs talking to Ian down by the river. Look, I know I've asked a lot of you already, but you have to find that kid. He deserves better than all this. Bite marks on their necks? That's the strangest thing I've ever heard. The family must have attack dogs with them or something. Oh, this is all I needed right now. What am I going to do? They'll keep coming back until all of us are dead. Thanks, kid. You're all right. Next time I see the family, there's gonna be hell to pay.
Thank you. You're not here to try and steal my secrets, are you? The secret of making Ultra Jet, obviously. Oh, damn it. Now the cat's out of the bag. Typical me. I suppose you could say that. Ultra Jet is almost double the potency of Jet. Perfect for ghouls. Jet barely affects us, you see. Only trouble is, it's almost impossible to gather the ingredients together. Say, you might be able to help me with that. It takes three things to make Ultra Jet. Two of the ingredients I got plenty of. The other one is a little harder to find. Sugar bombs. I distill it down to its base contents and add that to the formula, then presto, Ultra Jet. For every box of sugar bombs you bring me, I'll pay you 15 caps. So, you in? Fine, anything to get what I need. Now scram, I got some preparing to do. Get away from me, smooth skin. You looking for a problem? Get away from me, smooth skin. You looking for a problem? Cut it out. So, what did you bring me? He's my assistant and my backup, in case things get rough. I wouldn't mess with him if I were you. Nice work. The Ultra Jet's coming along nicely. So, what did you bring me? Sure. I stay away from them and they don't bother me. It's a good relationship. They live somewhere east of here. If you're feeling foolish, I think there's an underground way through their place, deeper into the metro station here. Yeah, as soon as you bring me some more sugar bombs. Yep, do what you gotta do. Thank you.
hope for peace, order, and security. These radical malcontents don't care about you. They don't care about America. All they care about is fulfilling their own selfish desires. Let's take a tally of these agitators, shall we? There are, of course, the raiders, those anarchistic ruffians who roam the wastes, preying on any and all, stealing, murdering. The so-called Brotherhood of Steel. Don't be fooled by their pseudo-knightly nonsense or supposed connections to the United States Army. These power-armored Boy Scouts are nothing more than common criminals with access to some antiquated technology. Criminals who have had the audacity to claim this country's most important military installation, America, as their own personal clubhouse. And don't be fooled, America. Those who have left the Brotherhood of Steel, the branded outcasts, are just as dangerous, even more so, being in exile. And what about the slavers of Paradise Falls? Frighteningly, irradiated ghouls of Underworld. And last but not least, the hideously mutated super mutants that have... state had its own professional baseball team. Imagine. Perfect, cloudless.
thought I heard guns. What's going on? Who are you? Yeah, I guess I should have known this would happen. You think I don't know that? You think I don't know what I did? I killed them! My own parents! It was the fucking hunger. That thing that's haunted me my entire life. You must think I'm some sort of monster. Of course it matters. The past is what's keeping me up at night. That night is like a bad dream. I can see parts of it, but I don't remember what happened. It was the fucking hunger. That thing that's haunted me my entire life. Help? How can you help? There's something inside me. Something completely messed up. I'm a mutant, a fucking freak. The only person I was ever able to talk to is my sister Lucy, and she's gone. No one gives a shit about me except Vance and the family. Can't you understand that? He's dead? You killed him? But he was my only chance to understand what the hell is happening to me. Maybe you're right. It was easier to run away with the family than to face what I did. Go back to Arfu and tell Evan King that I'm coming home. I have a few things to pack and I want to say my goodbyes to this place. Alone. Nice to see you again.
There she is, the heroine of the day. I know. I talked to Ian, and he told me everything you did. I don't know how you did it, but goddamn am I glad you walked up that ramp and lent us a hand. Thanks again, kid. Consider yourself welcome back here anytime you're in this part of the Wastes. I've been saving up stuff for emergencies, in case things with Arafu got tremendously bad. You're welcome to some of it if you like. Come on back soon. I may have some stuff for you. Welcome back to Arafu, kid.
Thanks for setting me straight on everything. She really misses being home, and she's asked about me in here a lot. You have no idea how much this means to me. Thanks so much. It actually kind of makes me feel better to talk about it. Go ahead. I wish I could answer that. I really do. I don't even remember it happening. When the hunger takes over, it's like being pushed aside. Like something else is controlling me. I can see what's happening, but can't close my eyes. I don't even remember exactly what happened until Vance knocked on the door. That's the weird thing. He has some sort of crazy sixth sense about, or something. Maybe all of our kind do. As soon as I was with the family, I really felt at home for the first time in my life. It's like all these people are my real brothers and sisters. I don't remember how long I sat there on the floor staring at my parents' bodies. It seemed like days. I wanted to feed, to eat their flesh. But it was like a little bit of me was holding on. Then, out of nowhere, there was shouting outside and a knock at the door. I opened it, and it was Vance. He seemed to know exactly how I was feeling inside. He took me under his arm and we left. I never looked back. Vance told me later that he was basically covering for me and allowing the family to feed at the same time. Since my parents were already dead, they drank their blood and left the mark on the wall. He didn't want Evan to suspect that I had done it. The irony is, they were stalking our town to feed anyway. It's almost like Vance knew this would happen. Yeah, okay. I suppose not. I was about 10 years old, and I was playing with Lucy down under the overpass. We loved throwing rocks in the water. We saw some wastelander trying to break open the Brahmin pens and steal one of them, so I ran over and told him to stop. He just laughed and pushed me away. When I fell, suddenly my head started to hurt, and my eyes got all blurry. It was almost like I blacked out. Next thing I know, Lucy was pulling me off the guy. I had ripped his throat open with my teeth. She said I, like, changed into another person, that I even glared at her and raised my arms like I was gonna kill her. The wastelander took a swing at me with some kind of club. I turned around and jumped on him. I tore his throat open with my teeth. If he wouldn't have done that, Lucy may have been killed too. I just don't know. Lucy said Mom and Dad would never have understood. She told me to keep what I did a secret, and that she'd try and help me. Thanks to Lucy, she was able to stop that from ever happening again for years. Every time I'd feel the hunger, she'd hold on to me and not let go. After a while, the hunger almost seemed to go away until, well, I don't know, I really don't. I mean, I'm not totally dumb. I know they were in stories and all that. But who knows, maybe Vance is right and vampires were just people like us who learned to control their hunger and drink only blood. I mean, vampires are regarded as feared monsters instead of hunted animals, like cannibals. Kind of makes sense. Yeah, okay. It's weird living in my parents' old house with them gone, but I'll make the best of it. Everyone around here is being nice to me despite what happened, so I guess it all turned out well. Thanks. Sounds good. Come back and visit me sometime.
Why don't you look where you're going?
Hey there.
Are those hot little potatoes? Because, you know, they're on the ground. And my very own landmine! Oh, just what I've always wanted. Well, always since I sent you out on this anyway. Now, tell me all about it. What was it like going through there? What's it like disarming a landmine? Lots of places are nowadays. Good work staying alive in tough conditions. It'll be a great example for the book. I know you may not want to see any more explosives for a while, but obviously you know your way around them. Have a couple rainy day toys of mine. And looking at this landmine gives me an idea. It's a terrible device that does terrible things, of course. But it's easy to make your own, too. Yep, you've done a great job. I just need to add in the section on how to cook rat, and this chapter's done. Here, for your services, I've saved up quite a few stim packs. Of course, you may need them. We still've got two more chapters to go. Well, I can't force you to work, I suppose. Have fun out there, okay?